Hello YouTube, my name is Toasty and I'm here with a quick review of the Flow Toys Contact Staff. This sucker retails for about $250. Do I love it? Let's find out. So this is the 60.25 inch contact staff from Flow Toys. It has six different lights in it, which makes this a 12F product, according to their terminology. So let's do a quick breakdown of the pros and the cons of the Flow Toys contact staff. I'm gonna start with the pros. The number one reason that I bought this staff was because I was looking for the most durable staff in the market. I think this may be it. This thing is damn near indestructible. I know because I've dropped it many times. I've thrown it. It's tough. So in terms of the most durable LED staff I've come across, I think this may be it. Also, it's very well balanced. It's weighted nicely for contact moves. I was afraid that something like this may be slightly out of balance for one reason or another, just because of all the separate components, but this is nice. Another thing that I love about this product, and I think I just love about Flow Toys, are these little silicone bits right here. So these two are called Flow Mass, and they're just meant to give a little bit of extra weight to the end of your staff to allow you to contact with it. I think every LED staff on the market should be using these. I previously had a staff from Neo Flow Arts. I dropped it a lot because it wasn't really weighted for contact, but had it had little weights on it like these, I think I would have liked it more. And then these silicone caps right here. Not only do they add good weight, but whenever the staff drops, it's going to fall on the silicone, absorbing much of the shock and basically allowing your electronics to not get rattled so violently again and again. Like I said, I think all LED staves on the market should integrate upgrades like these. I know that the electronics are going to last a lot longer because they're protected. Another thing I love about these is since it's using multiple lights, each one has its own battery. Let's say you're out playing around and one of your batteries goes out. You really can't tell that you're missing a light, especially when you're spinning this thing around. So it's nice to know that you basically have a little bit of light redundancy here, which is a feature I've never personally had because all of the LED staffs I've had before were one single battery, one single light per side. So that's a really cool feature. Now let's talk about the cons. My number one gripe with this product is probably something that most people won't even care about. And it's something that I knew about prior to buying this, but I needed to experience it myself to determine whether or not I liked it. And that's this. I would describe this as a slight internal rattle from the components jiggling around slightly because it's not perfectly snug in there. And I know that that's in order to keep them safe, but I don't really care for how it makes the staff feel when it spins. It just feels cheap, even though I know it's the opposite of cheap. I just don't like it. It may not bother some people. Many of the people who I let try this didn't even notice it. May not bother you, but I consider that a con. Number two is this silicone grip. I like that there's grip on this. What I don't like is that it's silicone. As it goes over your skin, it kind of pulls on the skin a little bit and the hair. Totally minor gripe, but it reminds me of wearing like a beaded bracelet on my wrist. Just the gentle tugging of my hair, that's not ideal. I don't really like that. So the silicone grip, that's just how those feel. I don't really care for that. And then also, when you flow, naturally you're gonna sweat, you're gonna get sweaty, my arms get sweaty. When I flow with this, the grip becomes very slick and it becomes very difficult to do contact moves and even to kind of hold on to it. Just because I'm not used to this slick silicone grip when it's wet. That may be minor to most of you. Some of you will probably say just dry yourself off and keep going. And yeah, you're probably right, but I consider that a con. Another con is Taking it apart is kind of difficult. It's not hard, it's just kind of strenuous. So these, the way these connect, when I first started playing with this, I hadn't watched the FloTOYS videos on their YouTube channel, didn't know that I needed special instructions for putting these together and taking them apart. So, but the way these come apart is you sort of take them apart from the side. Now, when you first look at these, it's kind of like, well, all right, did I just stick that in there, right? And you just press. That's what I thought you do. And so I did that a lot. Ah, and you see what happened? I jammed myself with the light. Actually, I just literally just did it. And ouch. So, you know, maybe that's ignorance on my part as the consumer. I had to go and watch YouTube videos to figure this out after I hurt myself repeatedly. Turns out you have to go in from the side. Much easier to do it the right way. It is a good design by FloTOYS. I just didn't know about it. So I don't really consider that necessarily a negative thing. It's just an education thing that I think their manual could have done a better job of. Another con is the individual batteries on this. I know I mentioned this as a pro earlier, but this is the flip side. When it comes time to replace these batteries and charge them, in my case, I have 6 different flow lights, and you know, you gotta pull it out of the tube, you've gotta take them apart, and you've got to individually charge these batteries. And that is kind of a pain in the ass, especially if I'm just trying to flow with this at a nightclub like I like to. So just switching the batteries on these is kind of difficult, and I'll show you in a second. You know, you look at it and there's a little thumb grip here. There's a little thumb grip where you're supposed to do it, and I'll show you. But you're supposed to be able to push down on this hard enough that it opens up. So I'm doing this wrong, right? Again, have to refer to a video on FloTOYS website. If you watch the video, it's hilarious because they have several different ways they claim you're supposed to open these. In all the videos, it shows them like really easily using their thumb, no problem. Maybe I have one that's not as good for whatever reason, but this was a pain in the ass, and I did not like this the first time I tried to mess with it. My 20th time replacing these batteries, I still don't like it. What they want you to do is use one light on the other, press on it right here, just right, without hurting yourself, but enough to pop this gate open. So I'm gonna see if I can do it really quick. Actually, I think you're supposed to use the back side, is what the video said. Okay, I got it. So that was a pain in the ass. I do not like having to struggle in any way to get to a battery replacement, to get my LED prop back in action. Imagine having to do that 6 times. That sucks. I do not like that. I feel like there could probably be a better design there. I consider that a con for sure. The amount of time I've wasted and the number of times I've hurt my fingers and fingernails. It's part of the reason that I don't really love this staff, actually. And for my last con, look at this. Just take a minute. The battery is so in there that you need some specialty technique to get this battery out without sticking a tool in there and damaging it. So once again, FloTOYS, they have tutorials on how to do this. I was not successful in most of their suggestions. The only one that I could get to work for me was the one I'm about to show you, and I think it is silly that they expect people to do this every time they want to remove the battery on their FloTOYS light. Let that sink in for a minute. You literally have to smash it against a table in order to remove the batteries, unless you're like Doctor Strange and have some sort of magic hand technique. I don't know, I don't like that. I want my FloTOY to be streamlined. I want it to be easy to turn on and off. I want it to be simple to recharge and operate. And while this has a lot of pros, it is a great staff. I do like a lot about it. I just don't know if it's the right staff for me, especially for the price tag. $250 for that price tag, I want to love my flow toy. I don't expect a perfect prop. I know that doesn't exist. But the point of these reviews is to give an honest take on these very expensive tools that some people consider toys, so you get an idea of how it really feels, what it means to own this and use this before you buy it. Do I like this staff? Yes. Is this the right staff for me? No. It might be for you though. So just to recap the pros and the cons once more, this thing is very durable. It's well balanced. It's got multiple batteries in it for redundancy in your lighting. It's got these nice flow mats and caps that really add a lot of weight and protection. The polycarbonate is very strong and protects your lighting. On the con side, that rattle. Switching the batteries is slow and kind of painful. And by that, I mean just opening the battery gate is hard. It was hard for me. Removing the batteries is really bad. Again, they have a technique. For me, that didn't work. Smashing it against the table, that's what they recommended. Don't like that. And finally, the silicone grip. You either love silicone grip or you hate it. I think I hate it. And if anyone from Flow Toys is watching, I just want to say, I do think you make an excellent product. I'm a big fan of the culture of your company and your product line. And I hope you don't take offense to anything that I've said. This is just meant to be an honest and fair review. Let me know if you want to talk about it. Now I have a question for you, YouTube. Have you experienced this staff before? What did you think? Did you like it? Did you notice anything that I didn't, pros or cons? Leave me a comment below, let me know what you think, and maybe I'll make a revision to this video one day featuring your information. So if you like this video and want to see more in-depth staff reviews, click like, subscribe, hit the little bell, because my next video is about the Wizard of Flow Fire Contact Staff. You're gonna want to see this.